Roxburgh Middle School. We're putting a video together for kids that want to get better at the game of basketball. Demonstrating today is Washburn's senior point guard, Alex Cook. The first drill we're going to do is called the George Mikan drill. We call it the Mikan drill. You come into the gym and we do this Mikan drill 100 times. Alex is going to go right underneath the basket and he's going to face the bleachers or he's going to face the wall. He's going to hold the ball in his right hand and he's going to scoop it up off the glass and he's going to turn around and catch it in his left hand. Show us, Alex. This is the first fight. He's going to catch it in his left hand and he's going to be facing the opposite direction and he's going to go up off glass with his left hand. He's going to catch it in his right hand. It's important to only use one hand. Shoot it with your right, catch it with your left. Now Alex is going to do 10 in a row. Okay, now we're going to do a drill we call the Moses Malone. Moses Malone was famous for this drill back in the early 80s, so they named it after him. What it is it's just a drop step to the basket. We do it with a dribble, we drew it off the pass, and we do it with a pump fake. I'm going to pass the ball to Alex, but you can also do this on your own. Alex posts up, Alex gives me a target with his left hand. I pass the ball to his left hand, he catches it, he pins it, he drops with his left foot and dribbles between his legs. His shoulders are square to the mat, and he lays it up off the glass. Target, drop step, shoulders are square, off the glass. Now we're going to do a Moses without the dribble. Alex is going to give me a target. I'm going to pass it to him. He's going to catch, drop step, and lay it off the glass. Moses without the dribble. Well, doing the Moses drill, you need to set up in between the bottom block and the next one up. Okay? Never want to set up down here. Periodically, you can set up here depending on where the defense is. Alex is set between the blocks. You never want to go too low because you're going to turn and you won't be able to use the glass. Okay? Alex now is going to demonstrate how you can do this drill on your own. He's going to spin it to himself. He's going to catch. He's going to chin. He's going to drop step. He's going to lay it off the glass with his shoulders square to the mat. Okay. Good. Now he's going to do it without a dribble. Drop step and up. Now he's going to do it with a pump fake after the dribble. Left dribble, pump fake, and up. 3 sets of 10. The next post drill we're going to work on is called the Dominique. The Dominique is an up and under move. You drop step, ball fake, which is the up, step through, which is the under. Alex Cook is going to demonstrate this for us on the left lane line, but on the right hand side of the floor if you're looking at the basket. Alex gives me a target. He drop steps, middle, ball fakes, is up, steps through, goes under, and up to the basket. He's going to give me a target again. This is a Dominique with the dribble. Gives me a target, drop step, ball fake up, and under to the basket. Now he's going to do a Dominique without the dribble. He's going to give me a target. I'm going to hit him with drop step up and under. Another Dominique without the dribble. He's going to give me a target, ball fake up, and under. Okay, now we did the Dominique to the middle. Alex is going to show you how you do a Dominique with a dribble to the baseline. He gives me a target. Dribble, ball fake up and under for the layup. Gives me a target, Dominique with a dribble to the baseline. Dribble up, under for the layup. Now Alex is going to do a Dominique to the baseline without a dribble. Gives me a target. Ball fake up and under. I want to get the D defender into the air and then step through and for the layup. Gives me a target. Up, step through. Okay, lastly, we're going to do a combo drill. This is the Dominique and Moses combo. Alex is going to catch, no dribble. He's going to ball fake with the up. He's going to crab dribble, and he's going to pump fake, and he's going to lay it off the glass. Okay, Dominique combo with Moses. Gives me a target. No dribble, ball face up. Crab dribble, ball fake, and off the glass. Shoulders are square to the mat, and he's ball faking twice. This is a combo with a double ball fake. Okay, Dominique and Moses combo. Gives me a target. No dribble, ball fake up. Ball fake. As many times as you practice it on the right side, you have to do the same amount of repetitions on the left side. Okay, Alex is going to do a Moses with a dribble on the left side. He gives me a target. Pass, dribble, shoulders are square, up and in. Now he's going to do a Moses without the dribble. Gives me a target. Up, no dribble, and in. Now he's going to do a Moses on the left side with a ball fake. Gives me a target. Up. Ball fake, and in. Alex is going to show you now how you can do a combo drill on your own. Spin it to yourself. Up, cross dribble, ball fake, and in. Alex is going to spin middle again. He's going to go up, and he's going to go under. First time with the dribble. Gives me a target. Drop step middle, ball fake up, and under with the left. Next he's going to do it without a dribble. Gives me a target. Up, steps under. Now he's going to do it without a dribble, and he's going to combine it with the Moses with a dribble. Gives me a target. Catches it, ball fakes up. Dribble, ball fake. And up and in with the left. Okay, when setting up to post up on the defender, we have a target hand that we've been talking about, and then we have a hand behind to feel where the defense is. If I feel that Alex is coming on this side, I'm going to put my target hand out here to the left, and I'm going to catch the ball, and I'm going to spin middle and shoot it here. If I feel him here and I feel like he's going high, I'm going to turn this way and have my target hand here, and I'm going to ask for the pass to be thrown to this hand, and I'm going to drop that here and move up off the glass. Okay, if he happens to go around front, then I'm going to seal him off here, and my target hand is going to be here, and I'm going to catch the pass here, and I'm going to go off the glass. What we like to warm up with sometimes is called full court two ball. Alex is going to demonstrate with two basketballs what drill we do in the full court. The first lap he does, he goes to the top of the key, he goes to half court, top of the key, end line, all the way to the other corner, top of the key, half court, top of the key, end line, and all the way back to where he's going to start. The first drill he's going to do is two ball same. The second lap he's going to do is two ball opposite. He'll be dribbling the balls opposite of each other for lap number two. The third lap we do is called between the legs. When Alex gets to each of his turning points, he's going to go through the left leg first, and then the right leg, and then here the left leg, and then the right leg, and so on. Third lap, between the legs. Okay, for lap four, at every turning point, we go behind the back with one of the balls. So lap four, every turning point, behind the back. And our last lap is lap five. Alex is going to do the two-ball spin. Two-ball spin at every turning point is our last lap. The next drill that we do are called commandos. What we do with commandos is similar to what we do with full court two ball, only we go from end line to half court, back and forth, and it's timed for 30 seconds. What Alex is going to do first is a commando called behind the back. Set, go! The third commando we do is called a spin. Just like in full court two ball, when we spin, we keep the two balls close to our body. Ready? Go! Now, what we're going to do is called two ball stationary drills. These you can do in your living room, in your basement, out in the driveway, at a friend's house, at the park, or if you can find a gym. These you can do anytime. What Alex is going to start with is two ball same with a kill. He's going to dribble the ball the same, and then he's going to kill it. It's a low dribble. Two ball same. And then low. Two ball high. And then low. Good. Next, we move into the two ball alternate high and low. He's going to start out with two balls high, and then he's going to go low, alternating them. Okay. Two ball high, now low. Ball high, now low. Two ball high, now low. Okay, now it gets a little bit more difficult. We're going to do two ball high-low. Alex is going to dribble with his right hand one ball high, and with his left hand one ball low. And then I'm going to say switch, and he's going to dribble high with his left hand and low with his right hand. Go. High with his right, low with his left, switch. High with his left, low with his right, switch. Now Alex is going to do what we call two-ball switch-ins. He's going to dribble two balls in front of his body, clockwise for five, and then counterclockwise for five. Go! Switch! First the right leg, then together, and then the left leg. Okay, now Alex is going to do what we call a figure eight. He's going to go around his right leg, leaving one ball in front, and then go around his left leg, leaving the other ball in front. Okay, now the most difficult one we do with two ball stationary are called chase-ems. Alex is going to go around his right leg with one ball, followed by the other ball, do a figure eight around his left leg, and then back to the middle. He's going to do it three times. Go. Okay, Alex is going to put all of these together. He's going to do two of each one, and I'm going to time him, and he's going to try and do it in 30 seconds. Okay, two balls safe. Okay, now we're going to teach you how to shoot. The word we use with beginning shooters is beef. It's for balance, eyes, elbow, and follow through. Alex is facing the basket this way, but I'm going to turn him to face the camera. What I like to do is have kids line up on a straight line. He's facing you with his toe. His knee is right above his toe. His hip is above his knee, his elbow is above his hip, his wrist is above his elbow, and the ball is above his wrist. This is one straight line to the basket. Now we just have to worry about how far we shoot it or how short we shoot it. We don't have to worry about left and right. Alex is holding the ball with his right hand. He's right-handed. He puts the ball down like this. His left hand makes a T. Here's the bottom of the tee. Here's the top of the tee. He brings it up. His elbow is in. So he has balance, elbow, eyes, follow through. His left elbow is slightly out on the left-hand side. When he shoots it, he will follow through with his right hand and wave goodbye. Now Alex is going to shoot a free throw. He's got his balance, his toe facing the basket, his knee, his hip, his elbow, his wrist, and his ball, and his eye are all going to be in line with the basket. So he's got balance, elbow, eye, follow through. Okay, now for the jump shot. Alex is going to make a V cut, and he's going to cut to the free throw line, and while he's getting there, he's going to have his hands up ready for the ball, and he's going to have his foot turned, so when he catches the ball, he can plant, and he can go straight up for the jump shot in that straight line position that we talked about. Okay, Alex comes in, going to come in, his feet are set, catches the ball, he's going to explode and shoot. When shooting a jump shot, you want to land in the same spot where you jumped. You don't want to land off to the side. You don't want your momentum to carry you into the lane. You want to stop on a dime, go straight up, and land exactly where you jumped from. Now I'm going to pass it to Alex, and he's going to pull up for a jump shot. The teaching progression for the two ball same, two ball alternate, two ball one high low, two ball I don't know because I forgot. Now that's not bleh. Okay, now we're gonna do nothing. Okay.